Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we are going to talk about how to take any corporate logo and transform it into a three-dimensional object for your use in projects in HitFilm. So the first thing we need to do is we need to get a nice clean copy of the logo that is purely like a line art object with a transparent background. So what I have here is a JPEG, which is not that at all. So you can use any photo manipulation software like Photoshop or GIMP or something like that to take care of this, or you can use HitFilm. So I'm just going to go ahead and use HitFilm. What I'm going to do is right click on this and say make into a composite shot, click OK. I will need to remove the white background, so I will do that by using a luminance key. I think a luminance key probably will be best. Laying it on there, I will just key out the brighter part. And I might want to up the tolerance just a little bit. I just need it enough. Now, I'm not fond of this piece down here, so I'm going to go ahead and just remove that. I will do that by masking it out. And I'll just do it this way. Okay. And so now that's gone. Uh-huh. And now all I want to do is I want to use that as a mat on a plain black plane so that I have a real clean copy of that. Okay. If I were to create a new plane and then, you know, make that invisible and just say set mat on that black, or, you know, on that black plane and then source that, it will not work. And the reason is because the set mat effect acts on something before masks and effects and things like that have been applied to it. So what you do is you add a grade layer above that, and then that sort of bakes that in, and instead of sourcing the actual asset, you source the grade layer above it. And now you have this lovely, very clean copy of that. In fact, if I put a fill effect on that, you can see just how clean that is. Oh yeah, that's wonderful. Okay, so what I will now do is say options, export this frame, and I will export it as a PNG file. And I'm just going to go ahead and call it Fantastic Beasts and click save. Now I'm going to bring this into an application called Inkscape. Inkscape is a professional vector graphics editor for Linux, Windows, or Mac OS. The good news is it's free and open source. If you go to inkscape.org, I will leave a link in the description below, then you can download this free application for yourself. After you have downloaded it, then we can fire it up and you can create a scalable vector graphics file in it. So now that I am in Inkscape, all I have to do is drag in my PNG into this workspace area. So I simply select this and drag it in and then say, okay, and there it is. Now I can use these arrows to resize this, and I will. Holding down the shift and the control at the same time will allow me to resize it in place. If I use the mouse wheel, it will go up and down. If I hold shift, it will go side to side. But if I hold control, then it will roll out. And I really want to roll out a long ways, and then I want to make this extremely big, okay? That's because the size differential between this and Blender is like this. It's about this much, okay? So you want a pretty small page there with a very large logo. Now what we're going to do is we're going to create a trace bitmap of this, which we will then be able to save as a scalable vector graphics file. I'm going to open up under Path, Trace Bitmap, and then I'm just going to say, okay, and you can see that it has created a trace bitmap. If I close that and I just slide this over just a little bit, you can see there it is. And if I grab my original PNG file, I can now delete it. And this is a vector graphics traced bitmap here. And what I will do is very simply say file, export, or sorry, save as a SVG file. So I have browse to where I have the Fantastic Beasts PNG file, and I'm just going to call this Fantastic Beasts SVG, saving, and now we're going to bring that into Blender. In Blender, I'm going to start by deleting the default cube, and then under File, Import, I am going to import a scalable vector graphics file, which is an SVG file. After browsing to where I have that file, I will go ahead and click on it and say import the SVG. And there it is. You can see it. It is sitting right there on the table, nice and flat. I will go ahead and click on it to bring it up. The first thing I think I want to do is just rotate it 90 degrees so that it is sitting upright facing the camera this way. Okay. Now you can notice that there's the center of origin point, and it's not exactly around it. So if I were to, like, say, for example, scale, it scales around that center of origin point. I could rotate around that origin point. I think just because I want it to be, I want that center of origin point to be in the middle of the graphic itself. The way you do that is under Object, you say Set Origin, and we'll just put the geometry to the origin point. So now that origin point is dead center in the middle of this bigger graphic, okay? From here, I can go ahead and click on this tab, the Context Object Data tab. And if I open up the drop-down menu for geometry, you can see Extrude here. If I look at it a little bit sideways and I just grab that and drag it, I can extrude that into its three-dimensional looking object. Now, if I want to, I can add a little bit of a bevel. So I might just click on this and add just a smidgen of a bevel. And I think I do want to. I'm very fond of that, actually. I think I will leave that. Okay. I can go ahead and offset that, but I don't think that will be necessary. So, but offsetting that basically just means I shrink it back down to the size that it was. I don't want to do that. I think I like it the way it is. Be careful with that, because if you have intricate tinier spots, then it may cause some problems there. Okay. And when you're very happy with that and you think it looks pretty good, then we will go ahead and convert this from this meta surf looking half circle with two dots on it into a mesh itself. Here's how you do that. You say Object, Convert to a Mesh from a Curve, Meta, Surf, or Text. And when you do that, it becomes a triangle, which is a mesh. And now we can use this as if it is an actual mesh. We want to go ahead and unwrap the texture of this. So this is very easy to do. All you're going to do is go to the UV Editing tab and click here. And I'm just going to hit the A key to select all. And then under UV, I will say Smart UV Project and click OK to unwrap it. And that, depending on how complicated that unwrap is, could take a little bit of time, but you can see it's all unwrapped there. Okay, now last week when I did this with just simple text, I went ahead and I went to the Shading tab and I went ahead and shaded it right here. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go ahead and do that in HitFilm this week just to be a little bit different. However, I am going to select the base material for it so that it's just easier for me to see when I bring it into HitFilm. So what I will do now is I will say File, Export, and we can export this as whatever you want. I'm going to export it as a Wavefront file or an OBJ file. So I have browsed to where I have the other files, and I'm just going to rename this Fantastic Beasts, and I'm just going to click Export the OBJ file. Then I will go into HitFilm. So back in HitFilm, where I had this original file, I'm just going to say Import a three-dimensional model. I'm going to select my Fantastic Beasts object file and say Open. It will bring it up in the preview window, and you can see there it is, but it is totally untextured. So what I will do is, under Materials, open up the Materials tab, and I will pick a diffuse map to use. I have decided to select a marble-style looking map. If I wish, I can go ahead and add specular, normal, and a bump map as well. From here, I can adjust the bump depth, I can change to a different illumination model, and I can make some other changes, maybe adjust the roughness, the reflectivity, so on and so forth. And when I'm ready, I can just click OK. Now, what I will do is I will go ahead and bring this object into my scene, and I think I will go ahead and import my base scene to do that in. Then I can go ahead and drag this into my base scene. I built this base scene, by the way, in a live stream. I will leave a card here if you want to go see how I did that live. I'm going to go ahead and move to the front. Let me grab this model and just drag it up here a little bit and maybe scale it some so that it is bigger. Go back to the front camera angle. Ooh, it's a little big. And maybe a little too big. I'll drag it down here. Basically, that's it. While I'm here under material, I'll go ahead and cast shadows and maybe cast reflections. And now if I sort of bring it around, you can see how it looks. And pretty much that's it in a nutshell. You can basically do this with any picture logo that you like, and it's very simple, very easy to do, takes almost no time at all, done lickety split, and boy, it sure is simple. So if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this kind of content, please feel free to like this video and subscribe, click the little bell notification icon, share it with your friends, and as always, thanks for watching.